How are you?
I'm fine.
Come and say hello to my viewers.
Hi, I'm Coco.
Yes, Covia. So how do you wash your utensils? As for me, I remove the foodstuffs, the grease and everything, and then I start washing. How about you? Leave a comment down below, let me know. Let me ask you, and how do you call kikombe in Kiluya?
Kikombe? In our language?
Yes.
Okay, in our language...
Which is
Kiluya.
Uh-huh.
We call kikombe... Sikombe.
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 Sihai.
My Luya viewers, did you hear that?
Sikombe. That is Kibukusu. Pure.
Kibukusu.
Pure Kibukusu, not Maragoli.
Thank you so much, Kovia. So you had that. Sikombe. And Kikuria, we say Egekombe. So there is some similarity because these are Bantu languages. So there are bound to be those similarities. So I hope you're taking note on that. So interesting, right? So, hiki, this is called a knife. Kiswahili, kisu. Kisu. Kisu is used to cut vegetables, fruits, and all that stuff. Yeah. And we have a spoon. Spoon in Kiswahili is called kijiko. And in plural is vijiko. So if there are two or many, we have vijiko. Kijiko is one. Vijiko, many. Together. And how do you call avocado in your language? In Kiswahili, avocado is called parachichi. Parachichi. So this one is a tap. We call it in Kiswahili, mfereji wa maji. Yeah. So, in plural, mifereji ya maji. And there are people who say, hii maji. That's very, very wrong Kiswahili. So many Nairobians, that's what you say, hi maji, hi mlango, hi kiti, stop it. To me, angeli sahihi, so don't just say, oh hi, it's hihi. I think there is a lot of influence from the English language, and we really need to speak correct Swahili, not hi maji, hi mlango, hi mtu. Hiviatu. Yeah, I think you should. Oops, what did I just do? Yeah, I think you should take note on that because this is our language. It's not even a foreign language, really. There is a lot of Bantu in it, there is a lot of Africanism in it. So, it's not really foreign, though, there is a lot of Arabic influence in it. And all that. Yeah, so let's take note on that and tuzidi kutukuza na kukuza lugha ya Kiswahili. Asante sana. I want to introduce to you a brand new character. What is his name? His name is
Lolo.
Lolo, come. Lolo, come here. You need to take a bath. Yeah, we have some ginger. This is called tangawizi. Then we have some garlic, kitungu saumu. Then we have onion, kitungu. And here comes Lolo. Lolo, say hi to the viewers. Lolo is saying hi to you. Lolo, how are you doing? How are are you doing? Yeah, so stay tuned onto this channel because we have a lot to share. We have so much to share. Yeah, so if there is any Kiswahili word you'd like to know, if there is any word that you would like to know how it's called in Kiswahili, or if there is anything that you don't know how it's called in Kiswahili, leave a comment down below. Then in my next video, I'll talk about it. So as for now, I'm so grateful that you're still supporting me, you're still commenting, subscribing. We are on the road to probably 1 million subscribers. Yeah, I just want you to support me in this venture. I like what I'm doing. Yeah, so it's my pleasure that everything is working out. And yeah, thank you so much, dear viewers. Let me end this video here because I see Lolo wants to have a bath. Yeah, and then we will talk about pets some other day. So thank you so much for sticking in. Goodbye, and take good care of yourself. Bye-bye.